Hello and welcome to It's Tomorrow News, and this is Hena Talati. At least 14 people have injured as a result of Mindil cyclone that hit Japan, media reported on Saturday. The typhoon left 10 people injured in one of the prefecture and 4 more in the prefecture of Ibakari, according to the broadcaster. Mindil damaged and flooded multiple houses and swept off roofs. The typhoon is currently moving along the country's northeastern coast. The pressure in the center of the typhoon is 970 hectopascals and the wind speed is 35 meters per second with a gust up to 50 meters per second. The powerful typhoon caused some local train services in Chiba and other prefectures east of Tokyo to be temporarily suspended. Several flights and ferries connecting Tokyo's Haneda Airport and outer islands have been cancelled. The typhoon is the regional name in the Northwest Pacific for a mature tropical cyclone. Residents in the affected areas are warned for the possible flooding and mudslides. The 16th typhoon of the year, classified by the Meteorological Agency as large and very strong, was forecasted to approach the Izu Island south of the Tokyo on Friday before moving over the ocean east of Kanto. Earlier tracking forecast has shown the possibility of the cyclone to make landfall on Honshu. Officials said coastal areas in the Kanto could see gusts up to 150 kilometers per hour, but he said high waves in the tandem with heavy rain could be the biggest danger for some areas. Tokyo may see gusts of up to 100 kilometers per hour. The Izu Islands, however, are directly in the storm's path. The agency had forecasted 200 millimeters to 300 millimeters of the rain on the Izu Island in 24 hours on Friday morning. As of Thursday afternoon, the typhoon was heading north-northeast over the Pacific Ocean at the speed of 30 kilometers per hour. With a central pressure of 945 hectopascals, it had a maximum 10-minute wind speed average of 162 kilometers per hour and the gust of up to 216 kilometers per hour. The storm appears to set to a weaken only slightly as it moves north and then northeast. The agency issued the high wave warnings in the areas including Okinawa Prefecture, the Amami Islands and the Izu Islands, as well as in the coastal areas of Shikoku, Kinki, Tokai and Kanto regions. Meanwhile, the authorities in Oman urged thousands of the residents in the coastal areas to leave their homes and head to emergency shelters on Saturday in the Gulf state, braced for the tropical storm Shaheen to intensify into a Category 1 tropical cyclone. The Oman National Committee for the Emergency Management called for the evacuations in the northern states of Barka and Shaham and the coastal areas including parts of the capital Muscat, where Shaheen is forecast to strike on Sunday, bringing the high winds and heavy rains. Oman Civil Aviation Authority said on Friday it expected Shaheen to strengthen into a Category 1 tropical cyclone within the next 24 hours, forecasting rough seas and urging residents to keep away from the low-lying areas in the case of flash flooding. The direct effects will begin from October 3 morning. High-speed winds of 30 to 60 knots are expected, so also very high thunderstorms. The wadis and low-lying areas are likely to get filled with the rainwater, leading to flooding of the areas around it. The waves will rise to 3 to 5 meters in the Sea of Oman, flanking the capital area. The National Committee of Emergency Management, Civil Defense and Ambulance Authority and the state's apparatus are on high alert, with teams mobilized and stationed at various flash points. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Hena Talati. For more weather updates like this, and please subscribe our channel.